It is a great joy to have you here again. I greet you wherever you are. In this video we will talk about the following. My dog has a dropped ear, causes and what to do. Let's get started. There are dogs of many shapes and sizes, all with their own characteristics. Some have short ears that are held upright. Some have large ears that fall past the face. However, it is not common for a dog to have one ear pricked up and the other not. In these cases, it is possible that the cause is a pathology or a health condition. In this video, we are going to see what can be happening when your dog has a floppy ear. Let's see if this is a normal condition or if something needs to be done about it. The same applies if both ears are drooping when they should be erect. 1. Is it normal for a dog's ears to be flabby? Many people may doubt whether your dog's ears should be flabby. It is important to distinguish between normal sagging of the ears and something caused by a discomfort or illness. If you have a puppy of a breed of dog that normally should have pricked ears, and you see that the months go by and they remain flabby, this video is of interest to you. Puppies are born with floppy ears. They have not yet developed in the physical characteristics they present as puppies can be much more different when they are adults. The simple fact of being a puppy is one of the most common reasons why your dog has floppy ears. The time it takes for a puppy's ears to stand up depends on the breed and the dog in question. For some, 8 weeks is enough. For others, 8 months. However, in general, a dog's ears should be pricked up after the teeth have finished erupting. If the puppy's ears were raised and then fell back after a while, it is likely due to one of the following problems that we are going to explain to you. 2. Dogs with floppy ears. You should be aware that some dogs will simply never have their ears pricked up. Due to the type of breeding, some dogs always have floppy ears. All dog breeds that have floppy ears will have both ears down. When one ear is flabby and the other is not, it is likely a sign of a health problem. 3. Your dog's ears do not stand up. As I already told you, it is normal for puppies to have floppy ears depending on their breed. However, this can be difficult to tell with a mixed breed dog, as we do not know if they are supposed to have their ears pricked or not. It is even possible that two puppies from the same litter have different degrees of flaccidity in the ears, and this is due to genetic inheritance from their parents. If you know that your puppy must have raised its ears and has already reached the stage of development where it should have happened, it is important to know that there may be a problem. One of the most important is diet. Puppies will need a specific type of nutrition to grow properly. When they are not given enough protein and other vital nutrients, one or more of their ears can go limp. There are also some medical conditions that prevent your ears from standing upright. 4. Causes of drooping ears in dogs and the treatment to follow. There are different conditions that can cause a dog to have one ear turned up and the other down. However, they are often accompanied by other symptoms. These other symptoms will generally be more obvious and you should take them to your vet to rule out serious ailments. When the dog is not treated in time, as can be the case with abandoned dogs, the ear may never lift. Unfortunately, this is often the case with stray dogs. They may have a flabby or misshapen ear due to malnutrition, fighting, illness, fungal ear infections, parasites, or other causes. Some of the most common causes are the following. Bite wounds. When dogs fight or play, it is not uncommon for their ears to be injured. Animal bites are often complicated by ear infections. Except for minor injuries, they will need veterinary attention and even surgical intervention to avoid deformations. Otitis media. Otitis is a general term for inflammation or infection of the ear. This can occur only in the outer part of the ear, otitis externa, but it can also occur in the inner ear, otitis interna, or even in the middle, otitis media. Some dogs are predisposed to otitis and, in these cases, they may need a surgical intervention to fix the problem permanently. 5. The dog has a swollen and flabby ear. Sometimes your dog has a droopy ear that is also inflamed. It is common for the swelling to be due to an abscess. This occurs when pus grows around the infection site. A bruise can also be the cause of inflammation and drooping of your ear. The main cause is fighting, parasites, injuries or simply a hygiene problem. It is important that you clean your dog's ears regularly. Never try home remedies to clean your pet's ears. If you think your dog's drooping ear is a problem, see a trusted vet as soon as possible. Would you like to have more professional information, and especially updated about your dog? Visit the website below in the description of this video. Do not stop subscribing to the channel, comment, and share the video. You are very well, thank you.